all about the clapback. Get your boss whack, Premier's funeral on Snapchat. Ha! You now tuned into the bad guy.
Welcome to the bridge where niggas can't come. Shots fired, panic if you want. I want Dev run. Handguns, keep it in my pocket if it's static, nigga.
What's good, y'all? Fist Vegas, the hardest voice of sports. Go ahead, hit that like button and subscribe to the Fist Unit while you at it. Y'all know what time it is. If you ain't with it, you best get with it. Now let's rock. Listen, hit the subscribe button, all right? Hit that subscribe button, join this Fist Unit army, and get Fist Unit tough. With that being said, ho, 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 and Merry Christmas, courtesy of Baker Claus. That's his new name. His new name ain't Baker Mayfield, it's Baker Claus. Baker Claus is handing out them presents yesterday. He was handing out all kind of gifts to the Packers defense. Now, I was playing with the family. You know what I'm saying? We was building gingerbread houses. We was playing Scrabble. We was eating our Chinese food. We was celebrating Christmas. I wasn't going to let that bum-ass scrub Baker Mayfield interrupt my evening with the family. All right, now, I did the Cardinal video last night because, you know, the family left. It is what it is. But I wasn't going to interrupt my family memories to shit on Baker Mayfield. He not important. He not. But don't think I'm gonna let him slide. You know what I'm saying? Just cause I don't clap you today don't mean I won't clap you tomorrow, next week, or the month after. If you violate, you know what I'm saying, I'ma violate you back. You know what I'm saying? That's what I've been trying to tell people. Just cause I let it slide today don't mean I won't wake up in a foul mood and clap your ass a month from now. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's never safe. If you break that 11th commandment, thou shalt not fuck with this Vegas, you know that's your ass. Whenever I feel like your ass needs to be had, pause. So Baker Mayfield, on this Sunday afternoon, December 26th, I'ma tell the truth about you. Red pills is on deck. I'm handing out red pills like a pastor handing out tithing baskets right now. All y'all take them, because I've been telling y'all for 3 years. Been telling y'all for 3 years. Over two different channels, on my original channel and on this channel, I've been telling you bums in Cleveland that he ain't it. He is sorry. He's trash. The only good thing about him is swagger. That's it. He looks the part, but he don't play like it. This dude threw four interceptions. He threw four interceptions and lost by 2 points. I'ma say it again. He threw four interceptions and lost by 2 points. With the entire season on the line, the Ravens are as dead as fried chicken. The Ravens are as dead as the ribs and my pork fried rice combo that I had yesterday for dinner. The Ravens are dead, and they're not coming back. Okay? No Lamar, no Hundley, two games. The Ravens is dead. You own the tiebreaker over the Bengals, and the Steelers are the Steelers. Like, God help them. I don't know how they win games, but they do. All Cleveland had to do was beat Aaron Rodgers. Their defense showed up. Their defense held Aaron Rodgers to 24 points. But not Baker Mayfield. He says, nah, I'm going to throw four picks this game. With the game on the line, wasn't he in like the 50? We got a big-ass TV, but I don't got the best vision. I think they was at the 50. I can't tell. You know what I'm saying? I could be wrong. I want to say they was at the 50 because I think they was at the 50 because I think they got like a first down or two. De'Ernest Johnson, I think, had like a big play. I forgot what happened. But anyway, he throws a crossing route, a deep end route. He throws a deep end route and gets it picked off for the fourth time. Baker, you were right there. You needed like one more first down, and you beat Aaron Rodgers, the MVP, in Lambeau on Christmas. But you failed. You were the Grinch to all those miserable souls in Cleveland. All those people in Cleveland who their only goal in life is to eat food and fucking grow fat and die. You were the Grinch to their Christmas. The people in Cleveland don't have a lot of things to look forward to. It's bad enough they live in Cleveland. All they have is their sports teams. That's it. You were all those little kids had on Christmas, Baker, and you let them down. You should be ashamed of yourself. All the kids you failed on Christmas. All them grown ass men who have nothing better to do than the roof of this sorry ass team. You let them down. Baker. You failed this city. You have failed the city of Cleveland. Oliver Queen should shoot an arrow at this bum ass dude. I swear he should. He threw four picks. Yo, they put a graphic on the screen, right? I lie to you not. They had a graphic on the screen that Baker Mayfield threw four interceptions in this game. Aaron Rodgers has thrown four interceptions in his last 469 attempts. Let us think. Baker Mayfield threw four interceptions in the game. Aaron Rodgers threw four interceptions in like 470 attempts. Let that sink in. You know, Devontae, and you know, it's so sad too, because Devontae Adams dropped the game when it passed. Devontae Adams dropped the ball. He smoked. He got open on a cover two. They cover two'd him. He split the corner to safety. He was wide open in the hole. He dropped it. Devontae Adams dropped the game winning ball. And Baker proceeded to throw another pick. You garbage, son. You're garbage. All right, you're trash. Accept it. You know what I'm saying? I thought it was Odell's fault, though. Oh, no. It's Odell's fault. Baker Mayfield plays better without Odell. Baker Mayfield won 11 straight games last year without Odell. Baker Mayfield is being held down by Odell. Odell what? My man Odell looked better in LA than he ever looked in Cleveland. Baker Mayfield still look like some shit. I'll wait. I thought Odell was hindering his growth. I thought Baker Mayfield was better when all he had to do was distribute the ball. He didn't have to force it to Odell. Y'all blame Odell for this bum? How dare y'all blame number 13 for this bum-ass dude performances? How dare y'all? I ain't got nothing else to say, man. Shout out to Aaron Rodgers, breaking Brett Favre's Packer record. He's not leaving, by the way. Aaron Rodgers is not leaving Green Bay. Okay, he's just pouting. He a little bratty. He's a little divish. They gonna give him $50 million. Aaron Rodgers, the way he was talking about Green Bay, almost getting teary-eyed at the end, was either the greatest con NFL has ever seen, or he was being genuine. I can't tell, cause I'm a Giants fan, and Joe Judge be talking me into believing all kind of dumb shit. So I could be gullible. But the Aaron Rodgers, that post-game presser where he was just talking about being grateful and Christmas and passing Favre and giving it to Favre's grandson, all this shit. I was like, yo, either he's the greatest politician at the quarterback position or he really mean this shit. I couldn't tell, but one way or the other, it was good shit. I ain't got nothing else to say, though. That's it, that's all. Subscribe to the unit if you rocking with me. My name is Fist Vegas, and I approve this message.